Let's continue with hypopressives today. So remember, you are always to start with effortless positions. So I want you to plan the right way. You know, when I went to learn this method, we learned a sequence standing with standing position and then going down until lying down. But I realized that the way that worked for my clients was to make their life easier. And the life easier was to start on the back. So we did already one exercise that is with the hands like that while you are lying down on your back. Let's go with the exercise number two. This, so you did that already now. You did it for 10 times, okay? And now we move to exercise number two. Okay, you're going to lie down on your back. Again, you do the same thing, you know, you lie down on your back. Please, it has to be on a firm mattress or a yoga mat, no soft beds. And then you're going to bend your knees. Look that for that position where the feet are comfortable. Could be with the feet far from you, could be with the feet closer to you. Just listen to your body, what is the most comfortable position. Remember, we're looking for effortless. Then, let's start again. Remember that someone is pulling your head, is making you bring the chin down. So you are flattening the back of your neck. Then, the shoulders, you're going to bring those shoulders down and back. Then, what you're going to do, you're going to separate the arms from your body. Bend your elbows, right? And then you're going to start rotating those arms until you touch the bed. So let me show you again. Open your arms. Bend the elbows. Here, you know, your elbows are like an L, right? From here, look at the position of my arms. I'm going to bring my hands down until they touch the yoga mat of the bed or the table. And after that, you're going to bring your hands up, your wrists bend this way. Okay? So you are like this. You're going to keep rotating your hands until your thumb touch the yoga mat. So let me show you how are you going to be. Imagine I am lying down, right? So this is the position that you're going to look when you are lying down. So you are going to separate your arms from you. Okay? Then you are going to bend the elbows, right? You are like this right now, right? Then you're going to bring those hands down. So imagine this is the bed, right? And then check what happened. I'm going to bring my hands up or my wrists up. There, like this. Fingers are going to keep rotating until they are in direction to my hips. But when you are lying down on the table, on the bed, these thumbs are touching the floor. You can experience some tightness, you know, your arms. But the thing is, with hypopressive, you are stretching postural muscles that are tight, and you're making the muscles that are weaker stronger. You're correcting muscle imbalances. So it's a good thing. So if you feel tightness but no pain, it's a good thing. You are stretching those muscles that need to be stretched out. If it's uncomfortable, you just keep it like that. So you're going to bend like that. And make sure that the elbows are going to go and touch the table. Remember, this is a position where you are already lying down. Just, I am in this position so you can see how are you going to look lying down on your table. So double chin, like this. Okay? Shoulders tend to go up, so you're going to bring it down. Okay, so let's go back. So actually, I'm going to show you so you can see better. Me remove my coat. Okay, so I'm going to bring this up so you can see what we are talking about. Okay? So, position of the feet. So, okay, so now your arms are already in the right position. Thumbs are touching the bed. And remember, the toes are up, Because what are we doing is stretching all the postural muscles that go from the heel all the way down to the neck. That is why our neck is flat. And then in this position, we're going to work on the breathing. Remember, when you breathe, you're going to focus on inhaling and expanding the abdomen. We all tend to breathe, and I would say it's a big percentage of people breathe and they're going to expand the chest, because we live in a life that is very hectic and busy, so we end up breathing like that. But we are going to do diaphragmatic breathing, so you're going to inhale and expand the tummy, exhale, bring the tummy down. So this is the breathing. And then you do the hypopressive, this posture for 10 times. Okay? So let's do this. So when you do the apnea, when you are laying down on your back, you have less distractions than when you are standing. So your back is resting. It's an effortless position. There are less things that you have to think to control. So it's going to be easier for your brain to reset and learn the new exercise. So when you are like this, sometimes if people are tight, they are going to feel like the shoulders and elbows are up. Try to bring those elbows down and the shoulders down too. I want you to put a little bit of pressure, you know, in this part against the table, because that's going to, you know, when you contract a muscle, like in this case, 10 seconds while the apnea lasts, at the end, those muscles are going to relax. It's a technique called contra-relax. It's neuromuscular reeducation. So when you do something like that, you're going to also feel more relaxed. Okay, so try and hold it. Let's do it one more time. Another thing that I want you to do to remember when you're doing the apnea, you already are in the position, right? The bed is the feedback for you to maintain the chin down. The bed is the feedback to maintain your elbows down, your shoulder down. Just that pressure that you're feeling is the feedback for you. So when you're doing the apnea, I want you to feel, I want you to connect with the contraction of your abdominal muscles, and also feel the contraction of your pelvic floor muscle. So I want you to try to feel it. And if you don't feel it too much, also with your mind, you know, just try a little bit harder, a little bit more, go a little bit farther. So you do the apnea, you just feel the contraction of your your abdominal muscles. Go a little bit farther and contract the pelvic floor muscle. Do it 10 times. And you will see, you know, with time, you know, at the end of 10 times, you're going to probably feel a little bit exhausted. Make sure to take breaks in between, because this position for 10 seconds, most of the time people can go 15 seconds. It's like the average, but the goal is supposed to be 25. It's a little bit harder. I have been doing hypopressive since 2014, and I would say is not easy. So just go as far as you can with the apnea, and make sure always to take a break with the breathing, with longer exhalation, so you don't stay without carbon dioxide in your lungs. You need to expel that, you know, because that is going to make you feel dizzy and kind of tired at the end of the day if you didn't expel of that from your lungs because you were holding it. So make sure to exhale deeper. Sometimes what I do a sound, I do ha, 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 because I want to make sure that I'm listening, that is going out of my system, because I want my system to be able to relax. So make sure to do that too. And just keep practicing. Remember, the success with anything in your life, anything that you do, is always a set of three things: commitment, discipline, and consistency. Okay, you are in the right path, you know, to improve your health. Hypopressive is a beautiful method, because hypopressive is not just about making, you know, putting everything back in place. It's like a puzzle, right? Everything has been has been moved, has been in different places. It's bringing everything to the center, and it's giving you more, like a stronger foundation, and you need that. You need that to move in life. If you have strong foundation that is here, everything gets easier. And the best thing about hypopressive is helping to prevent many things in the later in life, like for example, incontinence. And also, if you have hernias, it's going to help you to alleviate that, to, you know, because you are decreasing the pressure in the abdominal cavity. When you decrease the pressure, you know, the organs are in the right place, everything is in the right place, so the whole body is happier and is functioning right. Okay, my sweet people, I hope you like this video. Don't forget to write any questions, comments. I'm here to help you and to help you to heal. You know, that is what I want for you, to be able to have tools to heal yourselves. Have a beautiful rest of the day, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Mm-hmm.